Your ears are very important to us. Please hold on, and our program will begin shortly. The Soundcheck podcast is coming up. Please continue to hold. Up with the Soundcheck podcast and everything that's happening in the New Sounds Empire, just go to newsounds.org and follow us on social media. All of the icons are in the top right corner of the page. All of our other musicians are currently playing for other customers. Please stay with us, and someone will play for you in just a moment. From newsounds.org, it's time for another Soundcheck podcast, our series of live in-studio performances, streaming live on Facebook and YouTube. I'm John Schaefer. The Australian rock band Pond makes songs that can be angelic one minute, anthemic the next. Their songs are smart and psychedelic without being a throwback to the 60s. It's got a very contemporary sound. Pond's latest album is called The Weather, and they've been touring around the states in support of it. And they're here today to play some songs, beginning with the bonus track from The Weather. This is called Fire in the Water.
Yeah.
That is the band Pond playing live here in our studio on this edition of the Soundcheck podcast, and a song called Fire in the Water. Nick Albrook singing and playing guitar and being flanked on the left by Joe Ryan, on my left anyway, guitar and vocals, and on the right by Jay Watson, bass guitar and vocals, James Ireland behind the drum kit, Jamie Terry behind the keyboards. Nick, to you and the rest of the band, it's great to have you guys here. Thanks for
having us
on in. So we've seen a kind of a steady wave of music from Australia in recent years, most of it from Melbourne and a little bit from Sydney, but you guys are from the western end, from Perth. Yeah. You and Tame Impala both, right?
Yeah.
Two bands, and I know you guys have shared members a lot over the years. And so the more psychedelic stuff seems to be coming from that end of Australia. Is that?
I'm not sure. I don't know. I think there's a pretty widespread.
Yeah. Is there a?
I think it's just the same group of people. There's like 10 of us.
Well, I was just gonna ask. Is there a kind of how big is the community of musicians there in Perth?
Oh, it's really big. Mm. I just meant the sort of music you were talking about. But there's lots of good stuff in Perth. Mm-hmm. Lots of good artists. It's very big for the size of the city, I think.
How big a city are we talking about?
Couple of blocks.
It's like 1.5 million, but that's including it's a big sprawl. It's like LA, it's sprawled.
Right, right.
The actual city bit's not that big.
So, you know, there's a line in one of the songs on the weather about moving east. You know, is the East with a capital E kind of the El Dorado for people who are living on the west coast of Australia?
Yeah, it's sort of a cliche of like Perth people. You know, you go to Melbourne, go to Berlin, go to London, here.
Right.
No, I think Australians have a... There's like a really... There's the cultural cringe phenomenon is pretty... pretty huge, and a lot of people, especially young, you know, alternative people, get the feeling that they're bigger than where they're from.
Right.
I think if you think you're pretty cool, Australia's not gonna cut it. At least for your whole life, you know.
Yeah. It's funny because do you know Jen Clower?
Yeah.
I mean, she's written a whole song about that.
Oh, sure. Yeah.
You know, about that kind of Australian don't get too big for your britches sort of thing.
Yeah, the tall poppy syndrome.
We have that, but also we think we're pretty good in a weird way as well. It's this weird, like, arrogance meets bringing down arrogant people, you know, at the same time.
Wow. You guys are all kinds of messed up.
Oh, yeah, we're messed. That's what happens when you put people on a burning rock, you know, far away from there. Yeah.
Send all your convicts to one place and
let them sort it out.
Yeah. So, and that seems to be, you know, a lot of the lyrics have to do with kind of the Australian history and, you know, the way that Australia has kind of grown in the last couple of hundred years. When you call a song The Edge of the World, and actually it's in two parts, is that referring to Perth in particular being on the edge of the continent, or is that Australia?
Yeah, it's mainly talking about Perth. Like, some of the lyrics are like the sun setting over the sea and all that, and talking about limestone and those sort of specifics. Perth being like the edge, the antipode of the antipodes.
Now, you, Nick, and Jay, you co-wrote most of the songs on The Weather, right?
Joe wrote a couple as well.
But then there's Paint Me Silver, which was co-written with Todd Rundgren.
We just sampled, it's a sample of a Todd Rundgren song.
Ah, okay.
But we were very excited about that because it looks on the liner notes, you get to put like Albrook, Watson, Rundgren or whatever, you know? I don't know if when you do a sample you have to write that, but we wanted to just because it looked cool for us.
Well, you know, here in the States now, when you see the Grammys being awarded to Song of the Year, you've got like 12 people getting up to, the credits just go on longer than the song at this point.
Yeah. I've got to say, we've tried sampling things before and since, and it's quite hard to let you do it, but Todd Rundgren let us do it, you know. Very easily.
Because
he left some of the cash for us, which is pretty good too.
Yeah,
well,
uh-huh.
Yeah.
Because I suspect he sort of sensed kindred spirits.
Yeah, he's just a nice... Well, I like to think that that a few years down the track, if people want to like...
sample Pond?
Yeah, I mean, that's like the dream come true, isn't it? You know?
Okay.
For us. We've got to put more drum breaks in the song.
Speaking of samples, Nick, there are actual... what sound like samples off of the radio that are kind of interspersed through the album.
Yeah.
How carefully curated are those?
I don't know. Careful is a, in the pond universe, it's a difficult one. But yeah, no, they're curated. Like we honed in on particularly like amusing or relevant things.
And yeah. I mean, it actually sounds like you were tuning down the dial on like an old analog radio.
Well, I guess lots of the best bits are where you you hear it change over. No,
right.
I think it was a real one. I mean, I don't think it was.
Oh, there was some bits that
maybe
like,
I can't
press
tell.
The white noise button.
I think the way Pond works is that it's not careful, and we don't like labor over things for very long.
Yeah.
But we work very deliberately for very short periods of time before we get bored and want to go to the pub. but for that like hour and a half, we're like very focused, you know.
All right.
So yeah.
Most recent album is The Weather. The band is touring in support of it, playing tonight at Elsewhere in Brooklyn and playing for us this afternoon as part of our Soundcheck podcast series here at newsounds.org. The next song you're going to do, Zen Automaton, not to get too deep in the weeds here, but Nick, you're going to have to change a word or two here.
Absolutely, yeah.
So we'll see how this works out, or maybe we'll all be heading to the pub afterwards when we've lost our 94-year-old license to broadcast here in the States.
Oh, no. we really will do our best. All
right. If I stumble because of that, that's why. But it'll all be
it'll
worth
be
it.
The FCC's fault.
Yeah.
All right. Here's the song Zen Automaton live performance by Pond.
An automaton couldn't crack that cone and drive the sword of human guilt right up to its diamond hilt. I read it on my phone. Holy grail, is that Sir Ian McGowan leaning from
That is Pond with a version of the song Zen Automaton, which is from their most recent album called The Weather. Nick, you looked pretty pleased with yourself when you made it through the Ringo Bloody Star part of the song.
It was clever.
Yeah, that's very good.
It's the most I've used my brain in like 6 weeks.
I like with Ringo Star as well. It's made it sound extra like Scouser.
Extra Walker.
Yeah.
Do you speak Scouse?
I do not know.
But you can fake it when the situation calls for it.
Yeah.
Okay. The brand of English spoken in Liverpool. So I mentioned The Weather's the most recent album, but there is new material. I mean, the song 16 Days, for example. Yeah. So have you guys already started on the next album cycle?
The site? No.
We were supposed to be kind of starting at this tour. It was supposed to be the start of it, but we had to push back at the release of the record because a sample didn't get cleared. So we had to take it off the... we don't actually do that very often. It's kind of like one song an album. But yeah. It was on the artwork. Like the track list was on the artwork. So you have to change the artwork and the vinyl and all that. So it got pushed back. But... But it's great because we get more time to put the new songs in the set and work on it, mm-hmm. and like build it up before the album comes out.
Is that different for you guys to have the chance to kind of workshop things on the road before going into the studio?
Oh, it's already recorded. It's just...
So the album is
yeah, it's all done. It's all okay. Yeah. But it's like we're kind of like a cover band of ourselves. Like we won't record it like this. We record it in bits and pieces.
Sure.
And then we have to like allocate some piano that we don't have, or like a 10 synth parts to the drums or something. I don't know.
So Jay, when you were saying work it out on the road, you didn't mean work out the songs. You meant work out the arrangements of the live.
Yeah, and like it can take a while for us to be able to play. So like when we make albums, we're not very concerned about how it's going to be done live,
right.
And then we have to we make them quite for us technically challenging, mm-hmm. and then it takes a while to work out how to do it well
for our tiny pea brain.
so in and amongst the various travels and performances you guys have been doing here in the States, there's a fun video of you guys shopping at Amoeba Records out in California.
Oh, yeah.
And who's the Nusrat fan?
It's me.
Yeah, Nusrat Fateh Ali Khan, the great Sufi singer, Kavali singer.
He's unbelievable.
Yeah, he was. He was terrific. Unbelievable. Yeah.
From Pakistan?
From Pakistan. Yeah. Actually had the privilege of him and his band coming in and playing live here.
Wow.
Awesome. Yeah.
Yeah, cool. back in the 90s.
What a hero.
So are you guys, I mean, you know, you like vinyl, you like to at least evoke the sounds of the analog age. Are you analog guys in a digital era? Is that your predicament?
No. We're not too concerned with vinyl, are we?
I think when you travel a lot, vinyl gets a trifle hard.
Yeah. even when you just move from one apartment or house to another, vinyl can be a drag.
I think with analog and digital recording techniques and gear, I think like part of the fun of making music for a long time and getting better at it, you know, apparently better at it, is...
there's that Australian humble brag thing again.
there's lots of elements of like analog gear or old, because it tends to be older gear that is like desirable, and then there's elements that are rubbish, and then with digital there are elements that are like we couldn't even do this without, and then there are elements that are rubbish, you know, so it's kind of like fun to, I'd say we're like 50-50 on mm-hmm. old stuff, analog stuff and new technology.
Right. Well, certainly that was an analog flute that Nick was playing there.
Although we do want one of those MIDI.
MIDI
clarinet.
Yeah. The iwi, the electronic wind instrument. Is that what it is?
I don't know. Is that what they're called?
Yeah.
Not for Nick, but just to roll someone else
They can be used so well. There's some...
Play drums with it.
There's some amazing stuff.
Yeah.
Using that.
there's also, speaking of the new record, this song 16 Days, Nick, this will be on the new record.
Yeah.
There's an amazing video, hilarious video for this song, of you looking like a mix between Rocky from the Rocky Horror Picture Show and young Iggy Pop.
Great. Okay, I'll take that.
And yeah. Rocky from Rocky IV.
That's more like the cameraman.
Yeah, the cameraman.
Now, who is this... bodybuilding, is that a genuine
Fierce.
Bodybuilder?
What was his name?
Fierce.
Right.
His name was Fierce.
And in case anyone's wondering, he was from somewhere in Eastern Europe.
Yeah.
He was the real, legit bodybuilding article.
Wow. And now he lives in Perth.
Oh, it's LA. You don't find guys like Fierce in Perth.
Okay.
This is LA casting.
All right. Yeah, okay.
You know, you just go out on the street in LA and...
Excuse me, need an Eastern European bodybuilder for a video we're doing.
He was very patient, wasn't he?
He was lovely. Yeah. He was a very nice guy. And he got his big moment at the end where he got to like spin around and do all his moves. Everyone there in the room was just blown away in raptures. It was amazing. It's amazing to watch.
Hilarious video. You got to check it out for Pond's song 16 Days. But you're going to keep your shirt on for this performance, right?
Yeah, definitely. No, that was a once ever time. I live in this stuff.
All right, let's once again. Pond is here. They're playing tonight in Brooklyn at Elsewhere, coming to the end of their American tour, and stopping by to play for us on this edition of the Soundcheck podcast.
Well, I got 16 days to be a man about it. There are 5 pairs of eyes I need today, I count. Do you mind? Yeah. there a better man out there. So don't forget me. I need you to do much. How you think I might touch? Whoa, the whole world melts and my mental dreams fall. But now I know how a sucker fish feels. Shit, I better call my dad. I think I'm going with my dad. Not even sure if you're treating me bad. Well, I'm
that is Pond with 16 Days, a song which will be on the next Pond record. You guys have a title for it yet?
We do, but it's still a secret. I think it'll come out with the next song that comes out.
Okay.
Yeah.
I mean,
I don't know what it's why it's a secret, but we may as well keep it a secret. Yeah.
Do you guys use real vocoders, or is that like now a digital box?
That one.
Give him a shot.
Give them
well, I'd say it's digital, but it's a Boss vocoder. We have a really nice rack.
Yeah, I took off my headphones, but yeah, I'm playing vocoder.
We have a really nice old analog Japanese rack one in the studio, but this Boss little $100 pedal is really good at it.
Right, yeah. Right. So not a vocoder as it would have been played in the 70s, but...
Well, there's a setting on here called analog, so...
Okay.
Well, there was Talk Box with a tube, like Frampton, and then vocoder. Right. I think vocoders in the 70s were still kind of digital, right? I don't know.
Were all... Everything was analog, but...
I don't know.
All right.
I don't know if you've seen my board, but there's definitely no more real estate on here.
You and Nick both, you know, people who are watching this might have noticed Nick while singing, you know, tapping... boxes with his feet to
tap on the delay.
Yeah. So it's kind of like, it's almost like playing the organ. You got, you know, both hands on the guitar, but then the feet are playing too.
I mean, you can, you know, you've got a lot more leeway to be crappy.
I was going to say, you have a lot more opportunity for.
Yeah. Which is great for someone like me.
Yeah. Works for you, huh?
Yeah, yeah.
You're like living on the edge. On the edge of the continent there in Perth, and on the edge here live in performance in our
shout
studio.
Shout out to the edge. Wherever you are.
And tonight at Elsewhere in Brooklyn. And you guys are coming to the end of the tour, right? Will you be home for the holidays?
Yeah, yeah, we will actually.
Yeah. Very nice.
Yep.
All right.
I mean, I'll be
Can't wait.
Yeah.
Back to summer.
100 degrees.
Yeah.
All right. Now I'm beginning to hate you just a little bit.
Sorry, I'll be in London. I'll be freezing.
He's having a white Christmas.
Freezing my ass off.
All right, guys. It's been great fun having you here. Enjoy the rest of the tour, and thanks so much for being with us.
It's a pleasure. Thanks
for having us. The band is Pond. This is Soundcheck.